Is Tyler the Creator Pan? We're going to find out. We're going to find out. What's up, guys? We're inside Tyler the Creator's home. And we're going to try to fuck him. Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, I think he's successfully come
That's
out.
Good. Yeah.
I think, yeah.
The fan base was rough for a while. For yeah. sure.
Yeah, but I think he's like corrected.
Yeah.
Same with like all of, you know, I think they have like smart fans now.
Mm-hmm.
Which is good. I think all of the riffraff is gone.
Mm.
But you know, it's good. That's what they, you know, they were young.
Mm-hmm.
You grow up.
Mm.
Unless you're, it's like, how much has Eminem really grown up?
I don't know.
How much is he really like, it sucks that when you like listen to new Eminem, you're like, man, I wish this guy was doing pills again.
Like,
yeah. I wish this guy
needs to go through another divorce.
Yeah. Like, yeah, he was, you know, when he was doing pills and talking about killing his wife.
Yeah, but I never took it seriously.
Sure.
The beats were so good.
Yeah. Well, I was afraid of him when I was a kid.
Were you?
I don't know. Well, I liked it. Mm-hmm. I liked it. Like, I would, you know, he was on TRL all the time. And
right.
I, you know, he'd perform at all the MTV, you know, award shows and shit. And I was like, I thought, you know, at the time, I was in second grade or whatever. I was like, yeah, Eminem rules. But I was like afraid.
Eminem rules.
I was like afraid to think anything bad about Eminem because I thought that he would find out. Like, as a child, I was like afraid to have bad thoughts about Eminem because I thought that he would diss me.
He would not even beat you up. He would diss you in a track.
I thought he'd be like on TV like, fuck you, Brandon Wardell, for thinking.
God, every time you let us open the window and give us a look into your brain as a child, it answers questions and creates five more. What did you listen to as a kid, Chloe?
I was really obsessed with Weird Al.
Oh,
yeah,
okay.
My first ever concert was Weird Al.
Really?
It was Weird Al, the Warner Theater. I remember my dad posted up at the ESPN zone next door.
Really?
While me and my boy John Kowalczyk went to go see Weird Al.
The Warner Theater. First concert I went to was Spice Girls.
Okay.
And Ginger had left. It was devastating.
Oh, wow.
We were in like fifth grade. And we all cried.
Oh, damn.
When you left the band?
Out.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. But yeah, I loved Weird Al. I had it all memorized.
There was like a phase in middle school where I would only listen to like Weird Al and Flight of the Conchords. And I remember like literally telling somebody like, yeah, man, I only listen to novelty music, which is like, it's such a weird thing to like pride yourself on. Like, yeah, if you're not making jokes, you're not making jokes about like, eating a hot dog or whatever.
But I think a lot of it was like, I liked the music he was covering, but didn't know that music existed.
Oh yeah,
like,
it's so funny.
Amish Paradise. I was like, what is this song? Like, what a beat.
This beat
Amish Paradise knew a real
thing. It's so funny to hear. Yeah, hear like, whoa, this this song sounds a lot like Fat.
Yeah, yeah, I think that's truly what happened.
Yeah,
like, who is Michael Jackson?
What the hell? Yeah, why is it this guy off. Is? I thought this was a song about eating food and getting fat.
The white stuff. Who is this knockoff?
What was Yoda based off of? Wait, what was that song Yoda based off of?
What was the Yoda song?
Yoda? I don't know Yoda.
He's into the deep cuts.
Yeah, what was the song where it was like, he did that song that was American Pie, but it was about Star Wars.
This is your Anakin guy?
Yeah.
That's it's for kids. Yeah. Like, it is for kids. And, like, that's he's a legend. He was just on Hollywood Handbook.
Absolute
and it was
legend. Oh,
really
wow.
Really good.
Oh.
And, yeah, that's the thing is, like, he is definitely, like, he can play and he's, like, funny. But I'm not, no, it is weird if you're a grown-up, like, being, like, just like listening alone,
bumping,
like vibing out to Weird Al, like
working,
on the subway.
Working, yeah. Going to work, you have it on your beats at work.
Gym flow.
You're just like going
gym
to
flow,
your
listening to White and Nerdy on the treadmill.
Rolling.
Can you imagine going into your coworker's cubicle and you just kind of hear You hear Amish Paradise blasting out of their beats. They're working on a spreadsheet. That would kick ass.
Yeah, I mean, listening to Tacky. You don't know, that was like I think the newest Weird Al single.
Yeah. With Margaret Cho's in the music video.
It's like happy
because I'm tacky. It's a whole dance number. I remember I loved when that came out. He's like just jazz hands.
It's him.
You're full crying.
In tears.
It's like the song Happy by Pharrell, but it's about wearing like bad clothes.
It's him doing like, it's because like thrift
shop. I'm tacky. Yeah. Imagine being like a fucking like grown ass man. Like you're like you have a family home. You're at your office with headphones, and it's just like you're typing out spreadsheets in your headphones. It's just because I'm techie.
There you go. Yeah.
Damn. Oh, you know, you love it.
The thing that's weird about it, it's like so overly produced.
Yeah, I mean, you know.
Oh, who's that?
You know, it's fun if you're like.
Wait.
No, when I was a kid, this 23
ripped. Million views.
Yeah, I would love
as
this.
He should.
Yeah.
No, like
he
that's
should
like,
have 23 million views.
He does. You know, he deserves his like.
He's
his,
a god.
His.
Yeah. Here's Margaret
career.
Cho.
Oh, Margaret Cho is popping out.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Oh, fine.
She was the first stand-up I ever saw.
This is for kids. This is for kids.
Yeah. Oh, because that's because, dude, I was obsessed with Trapped in the Drive-Thru.
Oh yeah,
his Trapped in the Closet parody, which was about Trapped in the, and he had like a confessions parody. They're like, these are my confessions, and it's like. It's, you know, silly.
Yeah.
It's
I
fun.
Found
it's
so
like,
silly.
No, it's
like,
really,
you
know,
like
Weird Al was
literally
like he, Weird Al sitting here, I'm not, I don't
no,
think he would tell us that his music
no.
for adults.
No, yeah,
it
he's
was on
like,
brand. I watched a lot of Nickelodeon and listened to Weird
yeah,
Al.
Yeah, like that was, Weird Al was like,
there
would,
are people, there are adults that like still genuinely get down with the stuff they loved as a kid.
Yeah.
That's
which is
weirder
weird.
Shit. That's
but
like the
I,
dads in the Mario
of,
shirt.
Yeah, with Weird Al, I'm like,
the Mario
was,
shirt, guys.
That helped lead me into the path that I was
absolutely.
On. You know, that helped eventually, you know, lead you into comedy, lead me into comedy. Yeah. But I'm not going to like
Weird
listen
Al is our
to,
origin story.
I'm not going to just like be listening to Tacky like alone at the
although I might
alone at the
this,
crib.
I might take
drop
a Tacky
jog at the
club.
Yeah. But he you know, absolute legend.
Yeah.
I mean that. Oh, but yeah, I remember.
I mean, we wouldn't have Dicko Mode without.
Right. Who were the comedians you liked, like early on?
Who were the